Opinions expressed on this radio program do not necessarily reflect the views of this radio station.
My friends and I always tune into the Todd Levitt Law Show. Todd is entertaining, informative, and always delivers the goods.
Todd might not tell you what you want to hear, but he's going to tell you what you need to hear. And all you got to do is listen.
Hold on, Todd. Don't let go. It's time for the Todd L. Levitt Law Show.
Welcome to the Todd L. Levitt Marijuana Law Podcast. Good morning, good evening, and good night. I'm yours truly, attorney Todd L. Levitt, broadcasting and podcasting from the Black Diamond Group Mothership in the middle of Mitten, pure Michigan baby, in a beautiful, beautiful Craig Russell nutrient field with nutrients abound. Flowers are flowering. And everything is just peachy here, Craig. How are you doing, Craig Russell? No poem required for today's show because we opened up with Ra, one of my all-time favorite groups dating way back to the 90s. And I know, Craig Russell, it's one of your all-time favorite top five groups of all time. How you doing, Craig?
It's one of my top five favorite groups of all time named after an Egyptian sun god. How about that?
See, only you would know that.
See, that's what they're named after. I tried to remember that song. That song sounded really familiar. There was a lot of bands, I think, around that time. That was from like 2001, 2002, somewhere around there. And there's a lot of bands that sounded kind of like that. Like Filter sounded like that. And there was a couple other bands from that, like late 90s, early 2000s, that sounded like that. But a good song. Good song for Sunday with the sun out and everything. I am doing fan-flippantastic. How are you, Todd?
I'm OG Kush, doing well to myself, Craig Russell. And yeah, you can never go wrong with some OG Kush, right? But no, I'm doing great. You know, that song, I was putting a little rubber to the dirt last week, shredding the gnar on a single track, as I do each and every week. And I was just flipping through some old tunage I had on my dating back to when, you know, iTunes first came out. And I had that in my list of songs. And, you know, the one thing, if you're doing any type of outdoor activity and you're just destroying it to some good music, whichever music that is to you, Craig, then it could cause you to become reckless. And when I hear music like that, just like when I hear Metallica, whatever I'm doing, I'm going hard. Whatever I'm doing, I think we're getting a call into the studio here.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, that's right. We've got the 10th call coming in here, Craig. So why don't we take the 10th caller?
I say, you're caller number 10. You win, everybody. Hey.
That's right. And what do they win, Craig Russell?
Fake radio voice. You win raw on cassette. Congratulations.
How about for one penny, we're going to send you 10 CDs in the mail?
Did you ever do the Columbia House thing where you send in a penny for 12 CDs or whatever?
Full disclosure, not only did we, as we've talked on past episodes, slaughter someone's lawn with for sale signs when they were out of town because they wouldn't let us swim in their, you know, underground pool. We had one family in the neighborhood growing up in Berkeley, Oak Park, downstate, that had a built-in pool, and they didn't invite anybody. They were just snobby people. They did not invite any of us. We were stuck running through a sprinkler. The sprinkler really didn't do it. So when these people went out of town, of course, we went swimming in their pool and left some Caddyshack items behind, if you know what I'm saying.
I do.
But, those are some good old days there. But, I never ordered that, but I did order it for other people since the statute of limitations has told at this point.
Sure.
So a lot of people that I went to school with received those in the mail and had no idea how they got those and some other magazines that I'm sure their parents were shocked that they arrived in the mail. Let's just leave it at that.
Well, do you remember how the Columbia House thing worked? You picked out 12 CDs for a penny, and you had to tape the penny to the little card, but then you had to buy two or three CDs or cassettes at regular price, which was like 12 or 14 bucks for a CD and something. And all I know is people sent the penny in, and then they would send you back all the discs for a penny, and then you had to order the other ones. Nobody ever ordered the other ones. You always just got the penny ones, and that was it. But yeah, that was good times. Good times, good times. Hey, speaking of underground swimming pools, you know, in a lot of areas around the country due to the pandemic, a lot of like community pools are not open this summer. So you know what has spiked in sales in the past 3 or 4 months since the pandemic has taken place? And
sprinklers like I used to have to run through all the time. Tell me, Craig.
Not only sprinklers, but think about this one for a second. Slip and slide. Did you ever have a slip and slide when you were a kid?
No, we used we were so poor, we had to use garbage bags. So we would just douse the lawn. Once the sprinklers doused water all over our lawn, and I'm not even joking, we would go in the house, grab whatever plastic bags we could find, and just, you know, slide head first. And usually, you know, because I grew up in the city, we'd end up in a cement street over a curb. So no slip and slide here in this family.
That hurt. The Whammo people, the people who make slip and slides, reported sales up 500% from this time last year to this year for slip and slides. Since people can't go to the community pools, they're not open in a lot of places.
That's a great invention, by the way, isn't it? That's a great invention. I got another invention that somebody needs to come up with. I'm about to give out a multi-million-dollar idea right now for one of the listeners. You ready for this, Craig?
I'm ready for it.
And this, I think every single listener is going to relate to this. I know we're a law show, but we're giving out like entrepreneurship information here.
It's
I don't know about
Todd Tank.
What's that?
Instead of Shark Tank, it's Todd Tank.
I like that. I like that a lot.
Right.
Speaking of tanks, I have to go home and clean out my freshwater tank after the show of all shows here. Give them some fresh oxygen.
And take your medication while you're at it. Anyway, what's the
OG Kush, baby?
Yeah, okay.
No, here's an invention for, unless it already exists. How many of you out there, you're operating your trucks, your motor vehicles, and your children, your loved one, your girlfriend, or whomever is sitting in the passenger seat? I mean, we all know this, right, Craig? We've
sure.
all been there.
Yep.
So you're operating the vehicle, someone's sitting next to you, it's your car, and maybe it's a new car, maybe it's an old one, maybe it's a vehicle that you just want to keep clean, And that person in the front seat, what are they doing? They keep crossing their legs with their rubber soles, knocking into your dashboard, into your glove compartment, and scuffing it up. Not only that, but the side of, you know, the passenger seat door there. And you're driving, you're trying to pay attention, keep everybody safe. And all you're paying attention to, maybe it's just me, is the scuff marks that occur, you know, when someone is sitting there. So, and most of the time you can wipe it away. And even if you tell that person, hey, can you please be careful not to scuff up, you know, my glove compartment box there or my dashboard, the feet are still going up. The shoes are still crossing over with the legs. The scuff mark's still going to be there. And you have no choice. So I'm thinking of an invention that you can lay over when someone gets in a vehicle to prevent the scuffing from taking place. And I'm not naming names, Craig. I'm just saying it happens all the time to all the listeners. What say you, Craig?
I say you need to tell Jen to take her shoes off when she's in your truck. Come on now. You know, I think you remember earlier when you said maybe it's just me? I think it's just you.
No, there's no chance. There's no chance. And I'm not being specific. This is not about Jen because she's tiny. She doesn't even reach the floor. I'm referring to some of my guys, okay. with, you know, 6 feet tall.
Okay.
And so on and so forth. So, you know,
do you
that one goes out to Big Hair.
I was gonna say, do you ever ride in Big Hair's Prius and scuff up his dashboard and his thing?
He doesn't allow you to. He doesn't take anyone for rides in his Prius. So,
oh,
yeah. But hey, Craig, we are a law show, are we not? We have a lot of law to get to.
I thought we were. I was maybe sadly mistaken, but I thought we were.
My radio voice. I know you have a fake radio voice. Hey, Michael J has a fake. Michael J is the one that taught me how to have a fake radio voice. So my fake radio voice, which is normally talks like this if you meet me in person, goes out to my good dear friend Michael J. But no, you know, there's a story that appeared last week from the American Heart Association.
Okay.
There was a study that weed is not good for your heart. So, and again, the American Heart Association, pretty reputable organization there, however you look at it, they're supposed to be. And they came out with a study that weed is not good for your heart. So we're going to be talking about that and a lot more in the show here today, Craig.
That's right. We have to take a break right now in the Todd L. Levitt Law Show. When we come back, what is good for your heart? If it isn't weed, what is good for your heart? We'll dive into that coming up.
My heart is bloody enough.
Welcome back to the Todd L. Levitt Law Show, broadcasting and podcasting, by the way, on every single platform that exists out there. So if you missed any part of the show, be sure to subscribe on iTunes, iHeart, Spotify, Libsyn, Google Play, which I think is about to go by the wayside here soon. But yeah, we're broadcasting and podcasting. 50 countries have downloaded the show, tens of thousands of listeners a week. And we appreciate it, but all we do is just rabble on and rabble on, right?
Pretty much. Here's something you should know. You might have heard things in the news, or if you're online at all, that a bunch of different companies are buying different podcast platforms, like Spotify is buying a podcast. They're buying like Stitcher and all these other ones. Look, if you, wherever you're listening to the Todd L. Levitt Law Show or the Todd L. Levitt Marijuana Law Podcast, you're going to still be able to hear it there. Just continue to keep subscribing. And if you're new to the podcast, well, we thank you. Make sure you subscribe to it so you can get notifications anytime we put up a new podcast, which is most times either late weekend or early part of the week. And of course, if you don't get a chance to hear it on the podcast, or maybe you live in Central or Northern Michigan, we're always on 98.5 UPS every Sunday morning, like we are right now between 8 and 9. And that leads me to a question that I have for you, which is actually kind of an offshoot of a question from an email, toddlevittlawshow@gmail.com. Ellie, who is from Iosco County, wants to know, how is the bench there in Isabella County? How are things going? Where were you practicing this week? What were you doing law-wise?
Well, when you refer to the bench, that she's referring to the judges and possibly the prosecutor's office. What is it like to practice in Isabella County?
Right.
Before I get to that, and we do have a big topic to talk about, weed is not good for your heart, according to the American Heart Association. So we're definitely going to discuss that topic here shortly. This past week, I was practicing in Big Rapids in Reed City with Judge Jakelevic. Great judge. We attended law school together. We went to rival high schools when we were growing up in Metro Detroit. But Judge Jakelevic does a great job out there with sobriety court, with Susan Guernsey, Brad, Jacob, the great staff out there in Mikasa County, Big Rapids, and also in Reed City, that courthouse. Men and women do just such a great job. But we really appreciate Judge Jakelevic. Isabella County is also a great place to practice law. And we've talked about this over the last few weeks. You know, the prosecutor, David Barbary, does a fantastic job, in my opinion. He's the best prosecutor we've had since I've been practicing in Mount Pleasant, Michigan. His staff is fantastic, the prosecutors. And I'm a defense attorney saying this, but David himself was a defense attorney. And his father, Joe Barbary, used to be the prosecutor when I was attending Central in the 80s. And Joe has a great law firm. Joe Barbary here in Mount Pleasant, Michigan. He does a lot of medical malpractice, personal injury. He just wrote a great book, Joe did, on the new insurance laws in the state of Michigan. So we definitely need to get Joe on our show to talk about his book and what he does. Joe gives so much back to the community. He has a bicycle program each year. So Joe Barbary, a great lawyer out there, Mount Pleasant, Michigan, be sure to look him up. The judges in Isabella County, Judge Black, Spencer Nagel, and Judge James, and of course, Judge Duthie. It's a great place to practice. We have a really good bench going right now. I say that about all of Central Northern Michigan. I love our judges. So, and again, I don't say this, Craig, to gain favor for any of my clients. I'm exercising my First Amendment rights here on the show. People are asking me questions, and I'm just giving you my opinion. You know, at the end of the day, you go up against each other. You don't always get what you were asking for. You don't always get a yes answer. More often than not, you do get equitable relief on behalf of your clients. So that's a good thing across the judiciary. But Craig, is not good for your heart?
Hold on. Before you jump into that, I think it's probably also worth noting that you might not get the answers you like, but at least the process is fair. It's fair for everybody. And nobody's getting a preferential treatment or anything like that. Yeah, you might not win every case, but at least you'll know the reasons why, and you would want it to be the same way if you did win than if you don't win. You wanted to make sure that everybody gets a fair trial, a speedy trial, and everything is handled above the law. You know, there's no back alley gambling or any
What I don't like is the inconsistency. There are some judges in the state of Michigan, if you go way to the north, and I don't even practice in this county, and I'm not going to mention a county, but it is towards the top of the mitten. I'll just leave it at that. And this judge will send you to jail on a first and second offense for some minor misdemeanors, whereby almost every other single judge in the entire state of Michigan will not. Okay, so I've seen a lot of injustice out there over the years, and I will call it out just like I'm calling it out right now. I mean, I did appear before this judge years ago, and this judge has discretion. Some of the guidelines are zero, like each crime, a misdemeanor, zero up to a year. Okay, like a drinking and driving offense, let's say operating while visibly impaired is a 0 to 93-day misdemeanor. If it's your first offense, there's only one judge in the state of Michigan, Judge Kimberly Small, out of the 48th District Court, that will actually give you jail on your first offense. And I'm not sure if she is still doing that, but when I was practicing law in Metro Detroit, and Judge Small is a friend of mine. In fact, I think at one time she was on my radio show I used to have in Metro Detroit on another station. But that judge, she's the judge that put Jalen Rose in jail, a great basketball player from the Fab Five, Michigan, go blue. But there's another judge to the very north who you go before that judge, she will jail you. And on some offenses that other judges will not. And again, as an attorney, that's her discretion, but I just don't think it's fair. I think that for the legal system to be fair, that there has to be equal justice. And unfortunately, in some courts, and this is all over the country, because this show is downloaded all over the country, you can be in a courthouse in any state in this country, and you'll get a different outcome depending upon which courtroom you're walking into or which prosecutor you are dealing with. Now, I don't have that problem in and around the courts that I practice in, and I mean that sincerely because I would call it out. But when I did practice in Metro Detroit, that was the case. Depending upon who the prosecutor was, which county, which court, which judge, you'll get a completely different outcome, Craig. And that's not fair. That's not equitable. I mean, the laws belong to the people. The Constitution is our Constitution. The courts belong to us. These people work for us. And I do believe in term limits for judges. I believe in term limits. You have some judges across the country who have been on a bench for so freaking long that they have what's called robe syndrome. And you know, the power goes to their heads. And I'm not singling anyone out, but that does exist. And, you know, unfortunately, I have been around a lot of lawyers who have become judges. And yes, I have seen this happen. And you really want to stand up and say to these men and women, hey, don't you remember what it was like to be a defense attorney, to represent people? So yeah, that's my dissertation there. And the other thing I would say, Craig, is I do blame the legislators across the country in some of these states, including our state. In the state of Michigan, for instance, if you get a second OWI, operating while intoxicated, a second offense, now a lot of people out there will argue, you know, that person should go to jail. And a lot of judges will send somebody to jail on a second offense. But that carries a mandatory 5 days up to a year in jail. Mandatory 5 days. The judge has no discretion. He or she has to impose that jail time. I mean, again, you're saying 5 days. I mean, I know people personally that are in prison, you know, that are doing years. So when I say 5 days, I mean that respectfully to a lot of men and women out there who are doing, you know, serious time. But as far as these laws where there's mandatory times, I have a lot of issue with that too, Craig.
Well, I'm going to say a couple of things here, and then we can get away from talking about the law and talk about other stuff. But it's, you know, if you ever watch a baseball game and you see an umpire calling a balls and strikes, and sometimes they might call balls that are strikes and strikes that are balls, as long as they do the same thing for both teams, everybody's okay with it. It's called consistency, and that's what you want. When you are in front of a judge, you want them to be consistent. You want them to do the same thing. Don't give one client one set of statutes or anything like that, and don't give another client a different line. If you're going to consistently the same thing, bust people the same way, you want it to be consistent. I would.
Yeah, imagine. When I worked, and again, I, you know, the practice in central northern Michigan and even to the south, I mean, just it's a great place to practice. I take no issue, and I'm not just saying this because it's my livelihood. We have fantastic benches all throughout central northern Michigan. We truly do have judges, men and women who care. You know, I just I practiced for 12 years in Metro Detroit, Oakland, Wayne, Macomb, Livingston County, and I got out of law school in 1992. I would appear in front of some judges, and these judges would sit there and just rip a new you-know-what, not only to the lawyer, but to the person you're representing for no reason whatsoever. You know, if this judge, and I'm not going to call out any names, but I mean, I saw some things that were discouraging, to say the least. And the unfortunate thing is, in some of these big cities, the incumbents of all branches of government, you know, it's hard to beat an incumbent judge. Lawyers are afraid to run against that person for fear of retribution. I'm not saying it happens. I'm sure it does. But you don't see a lot of lawyers putting their names into a hat to run against an incumbent judge. And that's why I think judges should be termed out. I really do. I mean, I don't see there's any other than 6-year term. That's it. And I have a lot of friends that are judges that probably listen to the show. But I mean, hey, you guys are my friends, but you're elected officials and, you know, I'm a citizen and I pay taxes. You work for the citizens. And that's my opinion. You should be termed out. I don't want anybody to be in power too long where they let it go to their heads. And it does happen all across the spectrum.
And I'll then throw this out here. Although, granted, this is a talk about the law and things like that. It is a testament to this country that we're able to have this conversation, and you're able to say that there are some judges who practice the law fairly and some who don't, because we could be living in a country, you know, the United States, greatest country in the world. Let's not kid ourselves. You could be living in a country where there is no fairness, no anything. It's just you're going to jail or you're going to be killed, and that's just all there is to it. There is no trial. They might mock a trial, but you're going to lose no matter what. At least in this country, you've got a fair shot of winning and a fair shot of representing your clients and getting a positive outcome. In other countries, you know, in other countries that probably listen to this podcast where they download it. You download it in a, you know, in a place where there's not a whole lot of law and order, and it's a lot of, you know, they might pretend to have trials.
Yeah. And again, I have no complaints personally, and if I did, I would not vent them on this program. I mean, why would I do that? I'm not a fool.
Sure.
And when I say that I have no issue with central and northern judges in the courts in which I practice, I'm being damn serious. I mean, I think we have great judges and prosecutors in this region. They're hardworking men and women with terrific staffs. Most of my complaints come when I worked in a big city. And of course, you know, people are under a lot of stress in cities and courts and large dockets and whatnot. But I always say this, Craig, if you're a crappy person and that's just who you are, then whatever title you have and whatever job you hold, you know, it's going to reflect on not only you, but your staff and all those around you. I mean, I'm referring to a waiter, a judge, law enforcement. You could be an engineer. You could be working at a clothing store, and you could be general manager of a store. You could be a checkout clerk. If you're not a good person and you're miserable, then, you know, you're in your job and whatever it is you do, especially in customer service, that is going to reflect on other people. You know, when people ask us at our firm, why are we different than other lawyers? I mean, 5 lawyers will know the same judge. 5 lawyers will know the same letter of the law, what the statute is. But it all comes down to how you treat your customers, your clients. Yep. It's all about them. There is no ego in the practice of law. There should not be. Everything lawyers do should be for and on behalf, completely and in totality, on behalf of their client and the client's family. When you go to an attorney's office and that attorney is sitting there with their feet up talking for the first hour or two about his or herself, then you need to get the heck out of there. You see, you follow what I'm saying, Craig? Fair and much. That goes with different types of businesses. If you go see a counselor, a psychologist, a therapist, and they do exist, and there's a lot of hardworking men and women out there who care about people, but I know and I've heard stories and have been privy to counselors and therapists that all they want to do is talk about themselves when someone is before them seeking help. And they're paying that person an hourly rate, and all they're hearing about is their vacation their therapist just went on. Again, what kind of person are you? What kind of job do you do? I mean, are you someone with honor? Do you have respect for your job and who you are as a person? Leadership starts at the top, it flows down, and it goes right to your customers.
And on that happy note, when we come back from this break on the Todd L. Levitt Law Show, then we'll get to talking about if weed is bad for your heart or good for your heart.
And I'm going to get some OG Kush and chill out after that one, bro.
I'm telling you. Just don't have a heart attack. All right, we'll be right back.
No heart attack. Welcome back to the Todd L. Levitt Law Show. Coming back strong, Craig, with Ra. Do you call my name? Again, putting rubber to dirt last week, shredding the gnar on a single track. No big hair. I was going solo that day. No Vinny. Little John wasn't even biking with me on that day. So we decided to just turn it and burn it and destroy it right here on the show of all shows.
Wait. Little John goes mountain biking with you?
No, but Little John was supposed to be coming on the show today. Oh, okay. So I just want, I know, right? Sorry, Little John. We'll have you on next week.
I'm like, wait a minute. Little John has got a name, Little John, for a reason. He couldn't reach the pedals. How could he ride a bike?
He'd be on a little tricycle.
I wasn't going to be that way.
Actually, you and Little John would look really cute on a tandem bikes they have on Mackinac Island.
I can reach the pedals. I don't think he could.
Yeah, no, we love Little John, and Little John's coming on the show next week for sure.
Okay, so imagine, you remember Rocky, the Rocky movies with Rocky, obviously Sylvester Stallone, and Burgess Meredith, who was his trainer.
And then Adrian, how you doing? Yo, Adrian.
And then there was Paulie, the guy who always used to wear like the white tank tops and was the...
Yep,
the,
gotcha. Yeah,
that's who Little John reminds me of, the same kind of height and everything. He's about 5'4".
Don't I remind you of Sly Stone back in the 80s? People used to call me Rocky.
You were going to talk about your heart and weed, right? Correct?
Oh, so no more Rocky. Okay, yeah, we could talk about heart.
You don't. So weed is not good for your.
You don't remind me of Sly Stallone. I'm sorry, man. You don't.
Come on, Craig.
Come on, Todd.
You weren't hanging around with me in the 80s when Sly Stallone. And big shout out to my cousin AZ. AZ, he loves Rocky. So big shout out to AZ there. But look, weed is not good for your heart, Craig. Why do you think? Why do you think the American heart? I'm not saying that. And by the way, my heart loves when I cook eggs in bacon grease. And I don't think the American Heart Association likes that either. Oh. But you don't see them coming out with a study on eggs and bacon, do you? Well. No, they're only picking on Reefer Madness. Once again, the AHA says weed's not good for your heart. I know the listeners out there, they're happy. And that's all that counts.
I think they probably have mentioned the whole eggs and bacon grease thing in the past, possibly. Something about that sounds vaguely familiar. Why do they say that weed is not good for your heart? What is their rationale for that?
Well, I mean, it has to do with, someone smoking a product, whether it's a cigarette or otherwise, and then, the cells and the molecules and, the way your body is with your veins and your lungs and your heart and how that all works. I'm not a cardiologist. I don't even play one on TV, but that was the gist of the article, that putting smoke of any type in your body is not good for the cells and your heart and your vessels and whatnot, and it could lead to stroke. Look, I'm not a doctor, nor are you, Craig, although you do look like a doctor sometimes. And look, we're not advocating anybody do anything that a doctor advises you not to do. We're just discussing something the American Heart Association came up with. But for the most part, look, everything's bad for your heart, Craig. I mean, everything out there is essentially bad for you.
Yes,
right?
Agree.
So if there's one thing out there that makes you happy and takes away your pain and makes you happy or helps you sleep at night or helps you or someone you love with seizures or take care of anxiety or other issues, and it's not contrary to any medication you're taking or that a treating physician is telling you not to do, again, caution, I'm a lawyer, avoid the liability there, then why would the AHA want to go after weed? I mean, they're not picking on bacon and eggs, and I love eating eggs and bacon grease, Craig Russell.
Well, now, I'm going to ask you this, and we'll see how much you really read this article or not. So do they have a problem with the fact that you're smoking the weed, or is it weed in general? Because you don't have to necessarily smoke it to ingest things. You can have.
Yeah, the article did recommend using topicals and other forms of THC and cannabis. But again, I know men and women who are in their 70s and 80s who have a legal right to participate in the state in which they live in that have used these products for decades and decades, dating back to the 60s. A couple of my friends are heroes. They were in Vietnam. They're Vietnam vets, and we love all our vets, and we definitely have nothing but love and respect for the Vietnam vets and vets of all wars. But, I mean, you and I grew up, I was born in 65, and, I recall the POWs coming off the plane in, 72, 73, and we had a lot of vets in our neighborhood in Berkeley and Royal Oak. So, but I know some vets that are in their 70s right now from Vietnam that have been smoking reefer for a long time, and they've derived terrific benefits from it, and they are heart healthy. So, and again, I'm not a doctor. I mean, if you have emphysema or some other cardiac issues, I'm not telling you to go out and do something contrary to what your treating cardiologist has. I'm just saying that I completely unequivocally disagree with the American Heart Association for coming out with an article going after, weed and just jumping on a bandwagon for Reefer Madness right now. Again, I guarantee you, cooking eggs in bacon grease is a lot worse for your cholesterol, your LDLs, your high-density lipoproteins, your triglycerides than smoking some OG Kush on a Sunday morning, Craig, in a mothership.
What are you going to go eat when you leave the mothership today for breakfast?
I'm going to have some eggs cooked in some bacon grease.
Yes, you are. That's what I thought. We have to.
I'm not even joking about that, actually.
I'm sure you're not. I'm sure you are not. We do need to take a break on the Todd L. Lavella Show. When we come back, we will wrap this show up when we come back. We'll be right back.
like you saw this, don't you lie. At first you cry and then you hate those people, so you
to the Todd L. Levitt Law Show with a little Kush, a little Craig Russell, some bacon grease with your scrambled eggs today, and just happiness abound, Craig Russell. Welcome back to the show.
Well, welcome back. Your dreams are your ticket out, Todd.
That's funny.
You like that? You like that?
I like that. Hey, Craig, I got a shout out.
Oh, shout out. Please do.
Big shout out to all of our friends in Oil City. I have a lot of friends in Oil City. Oil City must be called Oil City. Mid Michigan, Mount Pleasant, this entire region still is a hub for oil and gas. We have a lot of men and women who work on the pipelines across the country. The companies are located right here in Mount Pleasant. And I'm just under the belief that at one time, Oil City, with the wells out there and all the companies, that's where Oil City came from. But my good friend, the Henrys, are out there. So big shout out to Jeff. Dan knows who he is. Dan, it was good talking to you this week. Paul Dentiman and Dan, Denny over at Oil City Sales. If you need a used car, this sounds like a commercial. Go to Oil City Sales and see my friend Paul Dentiman or Dan. My buddy Denny works out there. And we got Rick and everybody at Oil City Sales. Great people out there. So, yeah, Oil City. Big shout out to Oil City.
It does sound like you were, you know, kind of doing a little quick shout out there.
No, these people are like family to me, and I don't even know if they listen to the show, but I just, you know, I love my friends and family, and that's just a lot of love out there for everyone. Yes. And we're going to be cooking eggs and bacon grease after the show. But Craig, last week on what was I watching? Oh, Apple Plus on Apple Plus.
Okay,
I was watching the Beastie Boys special.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
And the two remaining living members, Mike D and the other one.
That's what
I can't remember
by
his name. Not Adam Yauch.
No,
the other two.
Isn't he Howie D or something like that? Maybe I'm thinking of somebody else. But anyway,
I'm not sure, but it was really interesting. So big shout out to the Beastie Boys. I grew up with the Beastie Boys, and, you know, I have fought all along for the right to party.
Yeah.
And, you know, not back in the 80s, I was at CMU, Fire Up Chips, in a big, big fraternity like Animal House. And when that song came out, I mean, we busted a lot of walls, I'm just saying.
Before we wrap the show up, do you have a quick complaint this week?
My complaint is to, and I'm going to out to the gas station on Mission, right over there on Michigan. I go there all the time. And my friend Jen, not my Jen, you know, not my Jen, but Jen works there. Some great people at this gas station there. And every time I get a soda, a fountain drink, the lids never fit the cups. I mean, can somebody please figure out? We just landed a spacecraft, SpaceX, into water after 40 years, and yet the manufacturing out there can't get a frickin' plastic lid to fit a cup of soda. And I'm just, every time I go in this branded gas station, I'm not going to out the gas station. It's a good station, good hardworking people. But the lids at this gas station never fit the freaking cups. And I'm fed up with it. I'm starting to bring Saran wrap with me. So I take the cup, I put the Saran wrap on, put the straw through it, and I got my own lid. I mean, I'm fed up with this, Craig. Get some freaking lids that fit the cups already.
I'm going to say two things to you. Do you remember back in the day, Domino's Pizza used to deliver soda? Well, soda. That's another thing I'm going to get to. They used to deliver pop in cups, and they would put plastic Saran wrap over the top of them when they would deliver them to your house. Do you remember that?
I worked for store 1029, 11 Mile in Coolidge in Berkeley High School and throughout college in the summer. Store 1029, Coolidge and 11 Mile. And at that time, Tom Monahan, who started Domino's Pizza, just bought the Tigers. And we were using bottles of soda.
Okay. Now, there's my second thing. Where the hell are you from? Soda? It's pop. We live in Michigan.
In Michigan, we call it pop, but this show's downloaded in every freaking state and all over the world. They have no idea what pop is, Craig.
No, but come on. You're using the word soda.
Come on, Craig. Get some OG Kush going and smile, buddy.
Todd, you sound like you're in California. Soda. It's pop. Come on.
Okay. I call it pop also. Do you call it a creek or do you call it a crick?
It's a creek.
It is a creek. Okay, we're from the city.
Yes,
do you call it a, what do you call something that the water comes out of on the side of a house? What do you call that?
It's a faucet.
Okay, again, I call it a faucet, not a spigot. We are clearly from the city.
Yeah, no,
I mean, I grew up in Detroit over by 7 and Berg Road and moved across 8 Mile. So, you know, when I say I grew up in the city, I mean
grew up in the city.
I grew up in a city where we had sidewalks and people that didn't let us swim in their pool, so we went swimming while they were on vacation and did some Caddyshack.
We drank pop, and I lived in the suburbs, so there's that.
You know what kind of pop just was the worst ever?
What?
Tab.
Oh, yeah. Ugh.
But you know, let's get rid of Tab.
But you know what was really good? You remember Town Club Pop? That was really good.
Town Club Pop. Town awesome. Club Soda, Craig. Yeah, we're an international show here, my friend.
Come on.
You know what's good for you?
What?
Products in states where it's legal to do so. This show, this attorney, it says it's good for you. I'm just going to leave it at that.
All right. And on that happy note, the show is over. We got to go.
Come on, Craig. We're just getting started here.
Todd, I know. Give me a pop and let's get out of here.
Nah, you know what we're going to do, Craig? We're just going to just turn it and burn it and destroy it. And in memory of Adam Yauch and all of us who grew up in the 80s and graduated high school in 1983 as I did. But now you didn't have to graduate high school in 83 or grew up in the 80s to just love the Beastie Boys. We're going to take them out, Craig, and just throw it out there. You got to fight for the right to party because we're not here for a long time. We're here for a good time. Make it a safe time. We wish you all a great day, afternoon, evening, or morning. We'll see you next week.
Todd L. Levitt Law Show, brought to you by Chad Malley Well Drilling of Rosebush, Clark Modular Homes, your most experienced and trusted builder in Mount Pleasant, and attorney Todd L. Levitt, not just a litigator, he's an advocator.
Opinions expressed on this radio program do not necessarily reflect the views of this radio station.